My name is Sheila Patel. I live and work in Mumbai with one of the affiliates of STI called Spark, Mahila Milan and NSTF. Slum or Shack Dwellers International is an organization set up in 1996 with a view to develop sustained organization of grassroots groups fighting against evictions to find new ways to sort their development problems and to create visibility and citizenship in the places where they live. STI provides three kinds of financing. The first one is to provide assistance and support for sustained federation building, creating conditions for women's savings groups to learn about finance and managing settlements and giving them voice. The second one is to provide grants that provide support both technical and financial to grassroots groups to experiment and explore solutions that they can produce and that they can negotiate with their cities. And the third one is for some of the country groups to work with international organizations for research, for practical projects and other things. On behalf of STI, we speak about the Urban Poor Funds International, which is the capital grants that we provide to grassroots groups to do projects. But all aspects of financing that STI does is to pool resources to give communities opportunities to drive their own development. While funds for projects were given from the beginning, the concept of the Urban Poor Funds International became formalized as STI began to get specific grants for projects that it could deliver to communities. It went to build federation capacities, produce learning, peer learning, sharing and exchanges. What is interesting is that right from the beginning, every local community has seen this as seed funding to explore something new. And it's leveraged its own savings, it's leveraged subsidies that were available and announced by their municipality or government, but which they could not get for many reasons. But they also were able to get loans from banks and use some of the past projects as evidence to get more resources. The UPFI funds show that although they are grants, poor people treat them as seed capital, and whatever resources of this they can recycle, they put back into their national urban poor funds and use it for other projects. The principle of this process is that the collective organization, the larger aggregation of SDI, supports each community and absorbs much of the reputational and organizational and project risks, which are many because poor people are not able to get development because of this huge cloud of risks that everybody sees in local development.